For years, the British government has reportedly tracked and stored billions of records of internet use by British citizens and people outside the UK in an effort to track every visible user on the internet. That finding comes from the Intercept website, which is publishing findings from National Security Agency contractor Edward Snowden's leak on government surveillance practices. Intercept reporter Ryan Gallagher wrote the story, joins me now via Skype from Brighton, England. First of all, explain the scale of surveillance that was happening from the British equivalent of the NSA, the GCHQ.
Well, the scale is quite phenomenal. I mean, it's hard to translate it when you just say the numbers, but they're talking about 50 to 100 billion metadata records of phone calls and emails and other communications every single day. So it's vast, vast quantities of information that they're sweeping up. And they were talking about by 2013 having in place the what they called the world's largest surveillance system. So a system that surpassed even what the NSA in the US has built itself.
Okay, when somebody hears that there's millions and billions and possibly trillions of pieces of data, they're going to say, you know what, how do you actually identify that this is specifically me that's doing this or going to this site or saying this thing in a chat room?
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, we did actually, one of the interesting parts of the story we just put out is that we had a bunch of specific cases where, for example, they had monitored something like 200,000 people from something like 185 different countries. So almost every country in the world who had listened to radio shows through their computer. One case they actually honed on, they decided to pick out one of these people, it seems like at random, and to see what websites he'd been viewing. So really it's a kind of all-seeing system that this, when you're gathering that amount of information, there's going to be something in there on almost everybody. So this is something that does have an impact and affects all of us, really.
So the GCHQ has much more lax oversight than even the NSA does. What are they doing with this information? You, in your article, you pointed to a couple of cases of almost corporate espionage.
With the information, as I said, we had the case where they were monitoring people who listened to internet radio shows. But there's a couple of other really, really fascinating and important cases where they've used this information to hack into European, major European telecommunications companies. The reason they did that is because they wanted to get into these companies' systems and steal information that they held in their systems, because that would help them spy on other people. And also in these cases, they caused this. These amounted to major cyber attacks in Europe on allied countries and companies in allied countries, causing millions of dollars in euro currency damage. The ramifications are quite severe, even just in terms of the European Union, for what the UK agency is doing in Europe.
All right. Ryan Gallagher of The Intercept, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me on.